Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome once again to our journey through the names of the Divine Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today we want to shed a light, or rather we ask Allah to shed the light of His name, Al-Latif. Yani Al-Latif is, some people translate it as the sublime, but in reality Al-Lutf, yani is when we speak about something transparent, or we speak about something very detailed. This is what a lutf means. So it means something invisible. And with regards to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is referring to the hidden wisdoms behind the things which happen in life. Very often we just don't understand why things are going the way they are going. We don't understand why people are suffering. We don't understand why very often it are the people who have nothing to say but useless things are the ones who are being listened to, and that the ones who have a lot of good things to say are the ones who are being neglected. We don't understand why people get away with the evil that they are doing, while others who are doing good might be falsely accused of doing bad. So many different things we don't understand, and this is where we say Allah is Latif. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Latifun bi'ibadi. Allah is Latif, meaning that we never have the feeling that His wisdom is disconnected from that which He makes happen in our lives, and that eventually He will show us why He was doing the things He was doing in our lives. What do I mean? When you look at the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, and you see that he was thrown into the well, taken away from his father, hated by almost all of his brothers, that he then was, you know, sold as a slave, then he was falsely accused by the wife of his master of wanting to harass her, and then he ended up in prison. So now when you are looking at his life path, then you're never going to tell yourself, well, this man will be okay. Let us say that you don't know he's a prophet. You look at his story today and you hear about a man, yani, who's in prison because he wanted to abuse the wife of his friend. And then you will say, okay, he's guilty. People thought that he was guilty, which is the most difficult thing. If he would have been in prison and people would have known or testified that they didn't think he was guilty of what they accused him of, then that would be easier to carry. That would be a lighter burden. But when people believe the slander and the gossip and the false accusations, then this will really hurt you. That's even if you then live on an island somewhere in Indonesia, for example, even then you will not feel happy, although that you are in paradise on earth. So Yusuf alayhi salam, when you look at that story and you make it contextual and actual, then you will say, like, okay, this man, his story is finished. But all of the suffering eventually led to him becoming one of the most important people of Egypt. And this is the way it goes. Very often, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to, when Allah wants good for you, then He lets you achieve things in life through a way which doesn't lead to that particular goal. Meaning, if you people now want to become a president or a leader, well, they're going into politics, they're going to do certain things, and then they say, well, now this is the way and the path towards my goal. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants good for you, He takes you to a goal that you didn't have in mind through ways that don't lead to that goal, so that you will never attribute it to yourself. You will look back and say, whoa, that is not the way to where I am today. So you will be humbled and you will be grateful and you will be thankful towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when He doesn't want that goodness for you, He makes you achieve your goals through a way which people usually, or a path which people usually take to reach that goal, so that at the end you look at yourself and say, I did it. Like Qarun. Qarun looked at himself and said, well, I made myself rich. And he forgot, yani, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the guide, that Allah is the protector, that Allah is al-Rashid, that Allah is al-Nur, that He gives light to your life and to your insight and your brain and so much more. So this is one of the meanings, one of the many meanings of al-Latif. So next time when you look back at where you are now, tell me, did you plan that? Did you plan to be where you are today? With people in your life that you have today, was that your goal? And then you know, every blessing I have was created by Allah. I was thinking that I was going in a direction, but He took me into another direction and made it better than what I was originally intending. So someone who has a Latif as his companion doesn't care whether he has the people against him or in his favor. وصلي اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.